Hello friends, welcome to another video of SlideScope. We are learning web development using MySQL, PHP, HTML, Bootstrap and various technologies. In this part, we will learn about inserting records in data table using HTML form, PHP and MySQL. So make sure that you have XAMPP or WAMP server installed and running, or any type of software that runs MySQL server and PHP. In one example of Bootstrap, in one chapter of Bootstrap, we created this hotel registration form for hotel management system, in which by filling these values, hotel will register here. So the concept is simple. This particular form will be hosted on a web server on some URL. Users will be able to see this form. And those who want to register in our hotel management system, they will simply go here and they will create some values here, and they will write some values here, they will register it, and then those values will be inserted. The values will be inserted here. So we have a table called TBL underscore hotel. You can already see that we have some password and enter password again here. So while registration process will go on, user will have to enter passwords, but again we will not store password directly here. So suppose you have written Apple, so that Apple, the encrypted version of that Apple password will be written here. So we have studied some SQL functions in the previous part, or in this chapter, or in this tutorial, sorry, in this tutorial you will have a complete section of SQL functions, in which you will see almost all important SQL functions, and so you will understand what is encryption and everything. So I will also tell you how you can use a function for creating encryption for user passwords. So now let's go ahead and discuss the basics of this. So we have various columns here, like hotel ID, hotel name, hotel email, phone, city, pin code, password, etc. And similarly, we have a form here in which we have asked the users to enter these values using the input tag. And now let's see. So the steps are really simple. Using get method or post method, you will collect the values, and then using get or post super global values, you have to first print the values that user will submit. So it is not necessary to print the values, but because we are learning that, so our first goal will be to print the values that are submitted. Now for this, we can go to our page where we have created this form. So here is the directory, and in this directory, this is our form, hotel registration.php. We can simply edit it, and now you will see that with every input we have some identifier here. So I have created a video where I have explained about creating a simple calculator using HTML forms and PHP. So from that chapter, you must remember that this name identifier can be used to take the values in super global variables. So you can see we have this form tag here, and this form tag can be used to submit values. It can be used to take values from users, and then we can process those values in PHP. And we can assign those values to different type of variables. We can process them, and we can then send them to database by connecting to our server and writing some SQL queries. So steps are really simple, but in this part our focus will be to get two of these values and print them in our page using PHP. So for that we will use a method here, and that method will be post. We are using this post method because there are passwords also here. So you have already seen in the case of get method, everything is visible in the URL. Whenever we submit form using get method, so those parameter and their values are visible in URL. Using get method can be helpful for creating search engines or applications where we have to filter results on the basis of some filters. But here, when we have to register users, when we have to register some type of a user, so in that case we prefer post here. There is another attribute here which is called action attribute, and the work of this action attribute is to provide the URL. So we can write something like url.php, or you can also write some server here like http://abc.com. It can be anything. It can be an example.com URL. It can be a file. So the main work of this action is when this form will be submitted, where will these values go, or on which page we have to submit the form. If you will not write action here, so in that case the form values will be submitted to this page itself. I will also provide some more information what we can write in the action attribute, but because this is just a simple submission of form, so in this case simply don't write action attribute, and the form will be submitted on this page itself. There are some server variables that we can use for this purpose, but here we are just simply understanding how we can print values that are submitted from a form in the page itself. You can see just below when my form tag is ending here, so I have my PHP and PHP opening and closing tag here on line 133 and 138. Now I will write a tag here called if. I will write this if condition, if is set. So is set function can be used to check whether a particular variable is set or not. You see here that in my case, the input type submit, this input type submit will be there in PHP forms, and with the help of these input type submit buttons we can submit a form. So this simply means that this form will be submitted only when input types, when this sub variable is set, when this post sub variable is set. That means we can write it here $_post. Sub. This simply means that whenever this button will be submitted, or whenever this button will be clicked, this $_post sub variable will be set. This $_post is a super global variable, and this is used to take values from a form. So from a HTML form we can take values that are submitted by users using this $_post sub when the form submit method is post. Now if it said $_post sub, we have discussed about this again in the chapter of our calculator. So we have a chapter where we have discussed about creating a simple calculator using get and post. So you can watch that video to understand more about these variables. So now simply if it said $_post sub, that means when this submit button will be clicked. So whatever code we have to write, after this, whatever we have to write in order to insert the values from the HTML form, so whatever values will be submitted by the HTML form, so we can get them here, but you have to write them inside this, because if you will not write if it said $_post sub, then at the time of when the form will not be submitted, or when the form is in its initial stage, we will get errors. So you should set these values, then only we have to print these values. So now we will write here echo $_post
echo dollar underscore post, and here you simply have to write the name of the identifier. So let's say we want to print the hotel name here. So echo dollar underscore post, that means we have to print the name of hotel. So and user will fill the hotel name, user will fill hotel email, and user will fill most of the values. And then when user will hit the submit button, so this variable will be set, and then we can print these values. Again, we are simply printing these values because we want to make sure that whatever values we are getting here are submitted by the users. In real, we don't print these values. We actually process these values for insertion in database or various other things. But because we are learning things, so that's why we are simply printing them, so that you can understand how we can get value from a user form. Now echo dollar underscore post hotel name and echo dollar underscore post hotel email. We will print these two values here so that we can see that we are getting the correct values that are entered by the user. And you can write dot and br here so that we can see the values in different line. Now we can go to this hotel registration form and we can print some values here. Let's say ABC hotel, and we can enter abc at example.com. You can fill these values also. So hotel city, hotel pin code, let's say we want these values also. So you can simply, or we can copy this line here. So we want hotel name, hotel city, hotel pin code. So you can see the name which we gave to our input tags, the value that is written in the name attribute, we are using that those identifiers in order to print these values. Simply we have hotel name, hotel city, hotel pin code. We can also write here for password it is pwd1. So we can write pwd1 and so on. Let's print these values: name, city, pin code, pwd1 and email. We are just printing these values so that we can verify whatever we have entered in the form, we are getting same values in PHP. And then in the next video, I will show you how you can remove special characters from them, how you can remove escape string, how you will use a function MySQLi real escape string on this, and how you will prepare these variables to be inserted in the SQL queries, to be used in the SQL queries, so that we can insert the data. Now simply go to your form, and simply you have to go to your form here, and now write name, email, city, let's say Delhi, pin code, let's say 110011. Then we have number of rooms. We have not printed number of rooms, but let's say it is ABC 123. And now register. So you can see here whatever values we entered here, so we are getting those values in PHP, or we are getting those values using PHP in the HTML. So this is how we can get these values. In the next part, we will see what other things we can do with them so that they can be used in SQL queries. And we can insert these values in our table, the table that is stored here in TBL hotel. So you can see we have already two dummy values here. What we can do to insert those values here. Thanks for watching.